In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon his last and beloved messenger Muhammad, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. The title of this presentation is Discoveries from the Quran, the 10th part. And in this series, I show, with the guidance of Allah God Almighty, the superiority of the knowledge of Allah in the last revelation to people of the Quran over the knowledge of people on all branches of knowledge, and how a believer can be a teacher of others by pondering upon this book, the Quran. And the among the topics of this 10th part is the one you see on the screen, similarities between the Quran and the human body. Similarities between this book, the last revelation to people of the Quran, and our body. And this title stems from pondering upon verses 1 to 3 of chapter 55 of the Quran, which reads this translation: The most gracious, he taught the Quran, he created humans. Now, these are the starting three verses of chapter 55 of the Quran. And as you can see, Allah starts with mentioning one of his qualities, that he is the most merciful, and then the most gracious, and then he tells us that he taught the Quran, meaning that he taught the Quran to people. Then he's telling us that he created our body. So if we think about the sequence of these verses, it tells us that there is a link between the Quran and our body. He taught the Quran, he created humans. There is a link. So let's look at this link. And we can find this link by pondering upon a saying of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, where he said, this translation, indeed, for everything there is a heart, and the heart of the Quran is Yasin. And Yasin is the name of a chapter in the Quran, chapter 36 of the Quran. So if we ponder upon the saying of Prophet Muhammad here, he's telling us that everything has a heart, and the heart of the Quran, of this book, is chapter 36, Surah Yasin. So if we think about this, now, if you think about this, we see that the Quran is composed of 114 chapters. The Quran is composed of 114 chapters. And the location of chapter Yasin, the one that Prophet Muhammad said is the heart of the Quran, is 36. So if we do a very simple calculation, if we divide 36 by 114, the answer is 0.31, and if we take the percentage, it's 31%. So this means that the location of chapter Yasin with respect to the entire length of the Quran, it's one third from the start, one third from here. It's about one third from the beginning of the Quran and two thirds from here. It's about one third from here and two thirds from here. So chapter Yasin is located after a third of the Quran, from the beginning, from chapter 1 of the Quran. This is the relative location of chapter Yasin of the Quran. If you go back to the saying of Prophet Muhammad, he's telling us that everything has a heart. So if you look at the location of our heart, where is the heart of the human body is located? If we do this with a very simple kind of calculation, if we divide our entire length into 8 units, 8 units. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units. If we divide the entire length of our body, 8 units. Our heart is located after a distance of 2.5 units from the top of our head. So if we divide 2.5 over 8, the answer is 0.31, so it's 31%. So your heart is about one third from the top and two-thirds from the bottom. If we compare this ratio that we found the location of the heart in our body and the location of Surah Yasin, where Prophet Muhammad told us that it's the heart of the Quran, we see a perfect match, 31%. So it's a great sign indeed that the heart, the location of the human heart, is at the same relative position compared to the entire length of the human body. So if you take the entire length of your body, the relative position of your heart is one third from the top, about one third. And if you take the entire length of the Quran, the heart of the Quran which is chapter Yasin, is about one third as well. So there is a great sign in this, and the sign is the following, the wisdom behind this, is that on this earth there are more than 5 billion people who believe that there is a creator who created their body, but they don't believe that this creator sent the Quran. So Allah God Almighty is showing us a sign here, which testifies that the one who created the human body is the one who sent down the Quran. The same one who sent the Quran is Allah God Almighty. And this is out of mercy to people to be guided to the Quran, to read the Quran, and to see the message of Allah God to them. So you can see the sign and the wisdom behind the sign. It's very important to see the wisdom behind the sign. Also, another sign in the similarity between the Quran and the human body, again, the wisdom behind this, that Allah is showing us that the one who sent down the Quran is the one who created everything. So another sign, and of course this is a promise that Allah showed in the Quran, told us about in the Quran in chapter 41 verse 53, this translation, Allah God will show them his signs in the universe and in their own selves until it becomes manifest to them that this is the truth, meaning the Quran is the truth. Is it not sufficient in regard to your Lord that he is a witness over all things? So Allah will show humans his signs in the universe and in their own selves until it manifests to them that this Quran is the truth. So let's continue with the link between the Quran and the human body. Now let's look how Allah sent down the Quran and he taught us the Quran and how he creates our body. Let's do a comparison between the two. So if we start with how Allah sent down the Quran, if we ponder upon the Quran in chapter 56 verses 77 and 78, which read, that is indeed an honorable recitation in a book well guarded. So Allah is telling us here that the Quran is in a place that's well guarded, in a preserved tablet. So if you look here, the presence of the information that Allah God wants to deliver to people in the Quran, which is in a preserved tablet. There's a place where this Quran is preserved in a preserved tablet. Now, if we look at how Allah creates our body, we have the presence of information required for the creation of the building blocks of the human body in a preserved place, the nucleus. So if you look at the nucleus, in the cell, the human cell, there is a nucleus, and within the nucleus there is information that is required for the creation of the building blocks of the body, the proteins. So the Quran was in preserved place, and the information required for the creation of human body, again, in the preserved place. To see the similarity between the mechanism of sending down the Quran and teaching the Quran, the mechanism of reading the words of Allah the Almighty to become a created being. So the second step is that, as we learn from the Quran in chapter 26 verses 193 and 194, which the trustworthy Ruh Gabriel has brought down upon your hearts that you may be of the warners. So the second part is that a messenger, the angel Gabriel, peace be upon him, he took a copy of the part of the words of Allah God Almighty from the preserved tablets, and he came down to the lower heaven. So the archangel Gabriel, peace be upon him, he took a copy of part of the words of Allah God Almighty in the preserved tablet, and this copy is the Quran. He came down with the Quran to a lower heaven, to our heaven, lower one. If we look at how the words of Allah are read in the nucleus, we see that a messenger called messenger RNA takes a copy of the part of the words of Allah God Almighty in the nucleus, and he goes down to a lower level. You can see the matching between the two. The third step is that the Quran, this message, is read by the first messenger Gabriel to a second messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him. Prophet Muhammad received the message from the first messenger Gabriel, peace upon him. Now in the nucleus, After the messenger mRNA takes a copy of the words of Allah found in the nucleus, he goes down and he delivers this message to a second messenger, which is called the mRNA, rRNA, the ribosomal RNA. Again, so this is another messenger. It's called the rRNA, the ribosomal RNA. So the first one is carried by the messenger RNA, and then it's given to ribosomal RNA from a first messenger to a second messenger. You can see the matching between the two. Now the fourth step is that the Quran, this message that the second messenger received, Prophet Muhammad peace upon him, he reads it to people to be implemented. That's the last step. Now in the cell, the second messenger, the ribosomal RNA, reads. This is the ribosomal RNA, reads the information to the workers in the cell to start implementing the message. So again, the Quran, when Prophet Muhammad received it, he delivered it to people to implement it. In the cell, when the ribosomal RNA reads the message, the workers in the cell implement the words of Allah to create proteins. So we see, brothers and sisters, the perfect match between the mechanism that Allah used to send down the Quran and teach it to people and the mechanism of Allah, how Allah sends down his words into the factories within the cell to start producing and start implementing his words. Again, this shows a great sign that the one who created our body is the same one who sent down the Quran, that this is the truth. Again, as Allah says in the Quran, Allah God will show them his signs in the universe and in their own selves until it becomes manifest to them that this is the truth. Is it not sufficient in regards to your Lord that he is a witness over all things? And to know more details about this topic, please visit my website at www.quran-miracle.com. This is the website. And you can email me at zaidquran@gmail.com. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all.